Welcome back to the show, everyone. Now, our next guest, she is one of the leads in a great series, and she's also avoiding something today as well, and that's why she's here.
Well, like most people, avoiding being outside in the cold, she is one of the stars of Hellcats. We're joined now by Heather Hemmens, who plays the role of Alice. How are you?
I'm good. Nice and cozy in here.
Yes.
Yeah, okay. So what are you avoiding? You're leaving here. You've been kind enough to fit this into your very busy schedule, and what do you have to do this afternoon?
Today, we're shooting a scene with Jake and Alice, and we're outside. It's kind of a walk and talk scene. And I don't know if it's reading on camera, but it's actually snowing outside. So
yeah.
I'm going to stay here with you guys as long as I can.
And
avoid doing that scene.
Know how filming television works. Shooting one scene can take an awfully long time.
It does. It takes hours. So we'll be freezing out there and we'll have all these layers on under our jackets. And they're really good with their hot shots, they're called. And we stick them to our rib cages. And I'm going to have little heater things in my shoes. So
little
they take good care of us, but still it's freezing.
But this isn't totally unfamiliar for you. You grew up in Maine originally, so snow is not like a completely foreign concept.
It's not unfamiliar, but still unwelcome.
Yeah.
I never was a fan of the cold. Yeah.
And you moved to LA just a few years ago.
As soon as I could.
And your first series lead is Hellcats. What a fun show to be working on. What was it like, the audition process? Because, of course, cheerleaders in the show. Yeah. You play the role of Alice. I'm assuming that you have to know some acrobatics. You've got a martial arts background. But what was the audition process like for you?
It was very grueling. I went in for several pre-reads just with the casting director. And then I met with the producers, and then on the sixth and seventh round, I finally went in and met with the CW network executives and did the screen testing for the show. So it was a long process, and we did have to dance. We had the dialogue scenes. It's overall very challenging because it's just not about the acting. So I think they were looking for someone for all of the roles that can be capable of the physical demands of the roles and also have, the acting
skills.
Well, and
people are very sophisticated, so, the physicality has to be realistic. Like, you guys actually have to do it. And when you look at some of the choreographed scenes that you guys are throwing down, it's sick. Like, I mean, there's some big stuff going on. Do you guys do it all, or do you have people that sort of help out a little bit as well?
We have an amazing team. We do all of the dancing that you see. We have to learn all the choreography, and then we do a lot of the stunting ourselves too, because we have to match what our stunt double is doing. So I don't do the backflips, and I don't do all the flying.
But
you have to look
issues.
Like you are.
Yes, nothing that could break my neck, but everything else we do, and it's we're sore.
That's
and we've got bruises.
It must be fun.
Well, yeah, because obviously, I mean, for you, acting is a love. But as Fiona mentioned, with your martial arts as well, obviously, there's that physical aspect to yourself and your being as well. So it's got to be fun to have those two things kind of mesh together.
It is. It's very fulfilling. I've always taken my physical well-being very seriously, and have learned a lot of great discipline through my martial arts, and I've thankfully been able to apply that into cheerleading, because I don't have a dance background. I was never a cheerleader. And on a show like this, you want to be very true to what cheerleading is.
Yeah.
You want to be very specific to the detail, because there are cheerleaders who are watching the show and critiquing every
move.
Do you ever read online and sort of find out what people are thinking about the cheerleading aspect?
I don't.
Yeah, good.
I don't want to know. Like, all I know is I did the best I could, and if
ignorance
I
is bliss.
Didn't hit that move, I don't want you to rub it in my face.
Now, tell us about your character, Alice, and where she's at.
Alice is a firecracker. When we meet her at the beginning of the series, she's like a wounded animal, and she's just like out to bite somebody. She's really, she's just broken up with her boyfriend. She's just been injured, and somebody's taking her place on the squad. So we've kind of moved past that now on the show, and we're starting to get to know her character more and learn why she is the way she is, and starting to see her vulnerabilities.
But her troubles are not over, and the episode that aired last week, we're going to see a clip from it right now.
Yeah.
Maybe you can set up what we're going to see.
Absolutely. Her troubles are far from over. She's always been out to get everyone else, and finally someone is out to get her. And so the clip we're about to see is as kind of someone taking their first stab at Alice. And she handles it well, but
she does.
A good first volley.
Okay, here is a scene from Hellcats.
Where did these end up?
A bunch of campus emails, 100 or so. The university is holding a full investigation. There are 6 images total. You want to see them?
I was there when they were taken. I don't need to see them.
Can I ask you a question? What the hell were you thinking?
I sent these to Jake a few weeks ago. He was in Dallas at an away game. I certainly didn't know he was going to do this, so please, wipe that judgmental, pitying frown off your face.
Don't get defensive. Strong, smart, independent women can do some stupid things. I know I have, and I'm not even that smart.
I'm drowning in sisterhood here. Do you have a point?
My point is, this isn't the first time that you've done self-destructive things, Alice. I'm concerned that there's a deeper issue.
Deeper issue? Please, they're just pictures.
That you're naked in.
I'm not ashamed of my body. I look fantastic in those pictures.
Well, these pictures don't just go away. Not nowadays. This could affect your future. I mean, if you're applying for a job.
It's not that big of a deal. Actually kind of
funny. Alice, there's that, hey, I look good. You know, what are you going to do?
She's justified. She's got her logic for everything.
Did you do a lot of research into the world of cheerleading? Because we all know from news headlines that cheerleaders can be vengeful beings. But what kind of research did you do into Alice?
Well, when we came out here to shoot the pilot, there was actually a Canadian national competition with the cheerleaders. So we went as a cast and watched that. We have cheerleaders that work with us. And actually, the people who are like the backup dancer, Hellcats, are people who have worked with Cirque du Soleil, who have been to nationals and to worlds cheerleading competitions.
Yeah.
So we're constantly surrounded with these people who know way more about it than we do. And you know, we're always picking their brains.
And how much did you, or do you talk about, you know, sort of the character arc of Alice as well? And because you guys are just filming episode 14, there's 22 in the season.
Yeah.
So do you know what's going to happen with her throughout the year? I mean, is that something that's talked about a lot?
Well, yes, we're definitely seeing an evolution of the mean girl to someone that we understand a little bit better.
Right.
But I don't want to disappoint anyone. Alice still brings the drama. And she's always
there's gotta
got
be drama.
She's always got something up her sleeve, and there's always a reason for conflict.
Well, and I always thought that those would be, and you know, I guess it's because in life I err on the side of nice guy, and I get that from you as well. So it must be fun to kind of play that character where you get that
the
little
bad
bit
girl.
You get to kind of, you know, throw it in people's face a little bit.
Yeah, she's got good one-liners, you know, little zingers, and I love her scenes with the guy she's dating on the show right now, Jake. They're always just, it's a weird couple, you know, and they both thrive on conflict, so really
well,
great stuff.
Congratulations on all the success
awesome.
On Hellcats. It's a pleasure to meet you, and don't get too cold out there today.
Yeah, that's right. Lots
okay,
of hot
watch,
shots today.
Hellcats, of course, the next new episode is December 1st on A Channel. Do not miss it.